Commander. What do you want?
What's bothering you, General?
I've seen a lot of horrible things in my days, and there's only one woman in this damn galaxy that helps me forget it.
If you feel this way, General, then why spread lies about her?
Because she rejected me. Me! Septimus Araka, General of the Turian Fleet.
I think I can see why you're upset, but spreading these lies won't make it better.
Look, kid, I appreciate what you're trying to do, but don't waste your time.
You need to start acting like a general if you want to beat this.
I spent all my life acting like a general, and what did it get me? Huh? No, those days are over. I'll just be what I am, a tired, lonely, worn-out soldier.
You're a damn general. Quit your whining.
Ha! You got balls, kid. There are only 5 people in this damn galaxy who talk to me like that. So you think it's that easy? Just straighten up and act like a general?
It sure as hell couldn't hurt.
Huh. Maybe you're right, Commander. Shaira's worth the effort, even if she won't have me back.
This is no place for someone of your stature, General.
All right, I'll go to her. After I've had a cold shower or two. Say, you're a bright kid. Would you be interested in earning a few extra credits?
What do you want me to do?
There's an Elcor diplomat out there who believes Shaira gave up his secrets.
And why is that?
Because I told him. Look, I just need you to convince him of the truth.
What makes you think he'll believe me?
You'll bring him proof. Take this data pad. It shows where I got my info. It will exonerate Shaira and convince the Elcor.
Who am I taking it to? Where is he?
His name is Zaltan. He's an Elcor diplomat. He's over in the embassies complaining about Shaira. Well, here's to soldiers acting like soldiers. Thanks, Commander. You know, you might make a good general yourself one day.
Human. Sincere apology, but I am here on business and cannot be distracted right now.
I've come to talk to you about your little problem.
Curious. What do you know about the consort and her relationship to me?
It was a Turian named Septimus who found out your secret.
Unbelieving. I know this Septimus, and he could not learn my secrets. The only way he could learn them is from the Asari consort.
Not true. Look at this.
Confused. This is difficult to fathom. If the Turian could learn this on his own, dismayed, anyone can discover my secret.
Septimus is a powerful man, and it wasn't easy for him to find.
Relieved. I suppose you are correct, human. Thank you for this information. Startled realization. I must speak with the consort. She will be most displeased with my actions. Anxious request. Please, human, if you will excuse me, I must go now.
I'm sure she'll forgive you. It was an honest mistake.
Doubtful. Perhaps you are right, human. I can only hope so.
Thankful. That was a great thing you did, Commander. Approving. You see, Din, not all humans are as you say.
I'm sure the Earth... stands to profit from this in some way.
Apologetic. Do not listen to my Volus compatriot. It was a good thing you did, regardless of your intentions.
This is truly magnificent. Most Prothean architecture I see is in ruins. The sheer size of this place is overwhelming.
Well, they've built themselves quite the lake. Wonder if anyone ever drowned in it.
Septimus has sent word. Apparently, he sought the consort's forgiveness. The consort is waiting to speak with you.
That's right. It was a long time ago, though. I barely remember it.
What drew you back to the Citadel and to the consort?
I don't know exactly. It may sound strange, but I simply felt called.
That's not strange. Many of us have felt the same calling, though you are the first of your kind to respond to it.
Really? I hadn't seen any other humans working here, but I didn't want to ask.
No doubt you are just the first of many to come. It's only a matter of time now that your species is spreading its wings. Welcome. It is a pleasure to see you.
You're with the Alliance? My brother's a private back on Earth.
Commander, I recently received a lovely note from Septimus. Thank you for speaking with him. Even the Alcor diplomat has withdrawn his campaign against me.
I'm glad I could help.
You are too kind, Commander. But I would not expect you to help me out of the kindness of your heart. I also have one more thing to give you, if you are interested.
What are you offering me?
I offer a gift of words, an affirmation of who you are and who you will become. I see your skin, tough as the scales on any Turian, unyielding. A wall between you and everyone else, but it protects you, makes you strong. It is that strength that people are drawn to. It is why you lead and others follow without question. You will need that leadership in the battles to come. This may be who you are, but it is not who you will become. It only forms the basis for your future greatness. Remember these words when doubt descends, Commander.
You have quite a gift, Jheera.
Thank you. Not everyone appreciates it as you do. Never underestimate the power of words. Here, Commander. In light of your efforts with the Alcor Ambassador, I would like you to have this small trinket.
What is it?
A small mystery. I have never learned its use or purpose, but I sense it is time for me to pass it on. And now I must ask you to leave. I have done everything I can for you. Remember my words, Commander Shepard. They will give you strength.
I see even the humans find the consort irresistible.
Hello again! The consort is very pleased with everything that you have done for her.
Any chance I can move up on her client list? I did help her out.
Yeah, she is grateful for your assistance. However, you have already been rewarded for helping her. The client list is a separate matter, and her schedule is completely booked for the next several months.
I think I'm done here.
Of course. Come back anytime.
So, Liara, you've spent 50 years studying Prothean ruins and artifacts.
Our travels now are somewhat different from my normal excavations. I would prefer lengthier studies and fewer explosions.
I think you've spoken for scientists everywhere, Liara.
Stand by, shore party. Decontamination in progress. Logged. The commanding officer is aboard. XO Presley stands relieved.
Anything you need, Commander?
Just trying to get a sense of where the crew's at. Thoughts?
I've wasted enough of your time for now, Commander. We'll have time for personal debriefings later.
What's your opinion on the last mission?
Dr. Tassoni. Seems like a sweet girl. Easy on the eyes. I mean, if you like the bookish sort.
We'll talk another time, Lieutenant.
Commander?
Commander?
What's your opinion on the last mission?
Not sure I buy Dr. Tassoni's story about her and her mom not talking. They're family, right?
I'm not sure I believe it either. It's better to have her where we can see her.
That makes sense. Too bad those ruins got destroyed. I mean, they lasted thousands of years. That's impressive.
We'll talk later, Williams.
Looking forward to it, sir.
Securing contact.
Ready. Say the word.
Ready.
Thank you.
After the get... Thresher moths are subterranean carnivores that spend their entire lives eating or searching for something to eat. Threshers reproduce via spores that can lie dormant for millennia, yet are robust enough to survive prolonged periods in deep space and atmospheric re-entry. As a result, Thresher spores appear on many worlds, spread by previous generations of space travelers. The body of a Thresher never entirely leaves the ground. Only the head and tentacles erupt from the Earth to attack. In addition to physical attacks, Threshers have the ability to project toxic chemicals and emit bursts of infrasound as a shockwave weapon. The Alliance first encountered Threshers on the colony of Akuz in 2177. After contact was lost with the Pioneer team, Marine units were deployed to investigate. The shore parties were set upon by hungry Threshers, and nearly the entire assault force was killed. Alliance forces recommend engaging Threshers with vehicle-mounted heavy weapons.
It appears they were lured here by the distress beacon.
These are Admiral Kahoku's men. We need to tell him what happened here. Ready.
Ready.
Thank you. You lead. I'll follow.
heads down.
Thank you.
I'm right here.
Securing point.
Thank you.
looks like the ship's deserted.
Most of the systems seem to be disabled. Only basic life support appears to be functioning.
Did you hear that? Sounded like footsteps. That was no accident. The whole place could be a trap.
Jacob's not going to make it. His brain was deprived of oxygen for too long. There's nothing any of us can do for him now except let him die with dignity. It's what he would want. I'm more worried about Julia now. She's showing signs of severe depression. I gave her some meds that should help, but I better warn the captain. Jacob's not going to make it. His brain was deprived of oxygen for too long. There's nothing any of us can do for him now except let him die with dignity.
Looks like that machine is keeping him alive.
I do not see any brain activity on the readouts. He is dead. This body is just an empty shell.
Leave him alone until we know more about what's going on here.
You are right. Better to just leave him be for now.
Dr. Smith gave me some meds to calm down, but I didn't take them. I can't. Not until I figure out a way to help Jacob. I won't give up on him. I won't!
Jacob is showing no signs of brain activity. There's nothing more we can do for him. He wouldn't want to be kept alive by machines, so we're going to disconnect the life support. Dr. Smith is worried about Julia's reaction, though. She can't seem to let Jacob go. The stress is making her implants flare up, causing intense migraines. It'll probably be easier for everyone if we don't tell her until after we shut the life support down. Give her a chance to...
Julia, what are you doing here? Why are you...
That was the compassionate thing to do, Shepard.
On me.
Thank you.
What's going on?
My name's Kate Bowman. I'm an engineer. I was part of the team assigned to bring this asteroid to Terra Nova.
We were attacked yesterday by Batarian extremists. I've been hiding since they arrived. I think they know the torch went out.
Why are they doing this?
I don't know, but if this asteroid isn't slowed, millions of people on Terra Nova are going to die.
If I find out anything, I'll...
I've gotta go. Good luck.
Hey.
Oh, God. I didn't mean to... Are you hurt?
You can't go firing your weapon at everything that moves. What the hell's wrong with you?
Sorry. I thought you were one of them.
Leave the fighting to me from now on. Commander Shepard, Systems Alliance.
Simon Atwell. I'm the chief engineer on this rock. Listen, we don't have much time. The Batarians fired up the fusion torches. You've got to shut them down before we hit Terra Nova. There are 4 million people down there, Shepard. My family. They live in Aronis. My kids and grandkids. Nice communities, good schools.
Batarians everywhere, and I need to shut down all 3 torches. Anything else I should know?
One of the torches is surrounded by live blasting caps. We were set up to excavate when we arrived at Terra Nova. I rigged them with proximity detectors. That tank of yours will set them off, so you'll have to go in on foot. Even then, they'll explode if you get too close. Just go slow and easy. You should be fine.
You set them up. Can you disable them?
Not from here. No. There are manual controls by the entrance to the torch facility inside the blast zone. You can disarm the caps there. One last thing. I had a crew working off-site when the attack hit. I'm worried about them. These Batarians are ruthless. I saw them smash the faceplates of guys working vacuum. And those Varan, I don't think they always wait for a corpse before feeding.
Any idea where I can find them?
They were running checks on our perimeter equipment. Easiest thing would be to tap into the transmission tower out on the surface. The equipment stations will show up on your sensors.
I'll look for them, but the torches have to be my priority.
Yeah, you're right. Saving Terra Nova is more important than my team. There were a bunch of engineers over at the main facility, but they're probably all dead. That or being held hostage by the Batarians.
A woman named Kate Bowman contacted me. The Batarians haven't found her yet.
Katie's alive. She's one of my best engineers. She signed on with her brother, Aaron, I think his name is. He's part of the security detail. I hope they're okay.
Give me a worst-case scenario. We can't stop the asteroid. Could the colony be evacuated?
Shepard, it took 30 years for the population to grow that large. I'm sure they're moving people to remote areas, but they'd never be able to get more than a few thousand off-world. We just don't have enough ships. No one does. Well, maybe the Quarians, but I don't see them suddenly showing up and offering us a ride.
Why were you moving this thing in the first place?
Well, the idea was to drag it into Terra Nova's orbit, mine it out, and in the end you'd have a basic structure for an orbital station. It's a lot cheaper than getting everything up into orbit from the planet's surface. The minerals we extract almost cover the costs.
What can you tell me about Kate?
Smart as a whip and bold as they come. I hope she keeps hidden, if they find her. Oh, Katie, don't do anything stupid.
You'd better find a good place to hide. If the Batarians come back and find you.
Yeah. I think I'll make myself scarce. Good luck, Shepard.
hear me? Getting all kinds of interference. Damn. Sorry. There's a lot of feedback. If I can fix it. In the meantime, just keep doing... If I can fix it. In the meantime, just keep doing...
anti-vehicle demolitions nearby. Proceed on foot. Warning. Ground-penetrating radar detects anti-vehicle demolitions nearby. Proceed on foot.
Thank you.
Who's shutting down the torches? I won't ask her again. Find this problem and deal with it. Get her out of here!
To me.
attack him. Heading to position.
Hold it right there. This doesn't have to end in bloodshed. Don't come any closer. We can do this the hard way, or we can end this peacefully.
I didn't think you Batarians knew the meaning of the word.
Look, I'm just doing my job here. Hijacking this rock wasn't my idea. I signed on to make a little profit. A quick slave grab, nothing more.
This isn't just a slave grab anymore. Millions of people are gonna die.
Don't you think I know that? I'm just following orders here. If it were up to me, we'd have already left.
Well, it's not too late. You can still leave.
I don't think so. Bollock would skin me alive and sell my hide out of spite. Crazy bastard. This whole mission's gone to hell and I'm gonna pay for it.
So why do you listen to him?
Good question. I had a bad feeling about this from the moment we landed. Now Bollock wants you dead. And what Bollock wants, Bollock gets. I can't change that.
Do you always want to be second in command? Get me out of here and I'll take care of Bollock. Then you can start giving the orders.
Huh. An interesting proposal. It certainly has benefits over the current situation. Shut it down. This is Bollock's problem now. I hope you're as quick with a gun as you are with your promises. For both our sakes.
Bollock will get what's coming to him. And so will you if I ever catch you in human territory again. Are we clear?
Perfectly. Alex, hold up in the main facility. You'll need this to get in. Don't underestimate him. He's a mean bastard. Let's go. We're getting off this rock.
Huddle up!
Securing point.
You up. loosen you up. On me.
More trouble than you're worth.
Let the hostages go, and maybe you'll live long enough to explain yourself to the Council.
I don't answer to the Council. Or to you. I'm leaving this asteroid. If you try to stop me, I'll detonate these charges, and your helper and her friends are all going to die.
I can't just let you go, Balak. Not after what happened here.
This is nothing! You humans have done far worse to the Batarians! We've been forced into exile, forced to survive on what we can scrounge up. It's been like that for decades.
Why take it out on these people? They didn't do anything to you or the Batarians.
Didn't do anything? Aside from colonizing a world that could have been ours? Aside from using resources that should have been ours? We were left to defend ourselves, but the humans were stronger than us. We knew that. The Council knew that. But it didn't matter. It was you. You and your kind are the only reason we're in this position.
How does killing innocent people make up for that?
We had no other options. Sometimes you need to get someone's attention before they'll listen. That's why we attacked you at Elysium. That's why I'm doing this. You forced our hand!
You attacked us first. When we retaliated, you ran off to the Council hoping for help. When you didn't get it, you hid. You've got no one to blame but yourselves.
Enough! You couldn't possibly understand. Actually, you just don't want to understand, and I'm done wasting my breath. Now, if you want your friends to live, I suggest you step aside.
You can go. But this isn't over. I'll find you eventually.
Maybe. But I made sure you won't follow me today. Those charges are still on a timer. Better hurry if you want to save your friends.
Perimeter clear.
left. Is that all right?
Letting him go was better than the alternative. I thought you were going to stay someplace safe.
There might have been something I could have done to help. I thought I should be here. I know this asteroid better than anyone.
You did it. Another hour and our course would have been irreversible. I ran the numbers, Shepard. X-57 would have struck near the capital city, the most densely populated region.
But that's not going to happen, thanks to you. Is Katie in here? Is she all right? Is her team?
Balak was holding them hostage. I let him go to save them.
Let a terrorist go or sacrifice innocent lives. I'm glad that's not a choice I had to make.
Will you get in trouble for that? I mean, he could do the same thing somewhere else, couldn't he?
Yeah, he could. Balak seemed like a practical man. Practical but callous. I'm sure if he'd been in my place, Ms. Bowman would be dead now, along with all the terrorists. But I'm not going to sacrifice people who happen to be between me and my target.
So what happens now? The bad guys get away?
Balak gets away today, but we'll still be after him tomorrow. And the day after that. Me, my crew, and every other crew in the Alliance. He'll run and he'll hide, but eventually he'll slip up and we'll get him. Bad guys never get away, Simon. Not unless the good guys give up.
Well, I wouldn't want you after me. Shepard, thank you for my grandchildren's lives. I don't think I'll stick around, though. Not with the team gone. Too many ghosts. It's time for me to get back and spend some time with my family. Before I go, I'd like to offer you something. Maybe you'll have more use for it than I will. As lead engineer, I get some quality items. Take your pick. You've earned it.
I need that heavy armor.
I hope you get good use out of it.
One more thing. You asked me to look into your missing engineers.
Have you found them?
Not yet. Can you think of anything that would help me find them?
See if you can tap into our transmission tower out on the surface. Their equipment sheds will show up on your sensors.
Take care of yourself.
Be well, Shepard. We owe you.
I can't believe you let Balak go to save us. I half expected you to just let us die, sacrifice the few for the many.
Then I'd be no better than the Batarians. Besides, Balak won't get away with this. I know who he is now. He can't run forever.
You sound like my brother. He was always so stubborn, but always willing to do the right thing, no matter what.
I wish I could have saved him, too.
It's not your fault. You did what you could. At least, Aaron died in the place he loved. He was the one who convinced me to join the team here. Said it would be an adventure. I don't mean to sound ungrateful, but I should see to Aaron.
I understand. You've been through enough today. I'll get out of your way.
Thank you. Oh, I don't even know your name.
Shepard. Commander Shepard.
Thank you, Commander Shepard. You're not exactly what I expected, but thank you.
That was a brave thing you did, Kate. Contacting me on the radio, risking your life.
Stubborn and determined runs in the family.
My father was in the Alliance back on Earth. I think he was disappointed none of us kids signed up, but he'd be proud of Aaron. Sorry.
How did the asteroid get all the way over here? Why wasn't someone alerted sooner?
The asteroid was scheduled to arrive in a day or two. Balak just sped it up. This rock is full of valuable minerals, but it was too far from Terra Nova to be profitable, so we attached some fusion rockets to it and drove it back. It was all going smoothly until... We'll get everything back to normal soon enough. Almost everything.
What can you tell me about the Batarians? What were they hoping to achieve with all this?
I don't even think they knew. When they first arrived, they were talking about getting us back to their ship. They wanted to sell us as slaves. When Balak showed up, everything changed. It was his idea to redirect the asteroid. Said it was the will of the Batarian Rebellion, whatever that is. They followed him quickly enough, but I don't know. I don't think they're all as fanatical as he was.
You've been through a lot. I'll get out of your way. So long, Kate.
I appreciate that, Commander. Goodbye.
Say, Shepard, you didn't happen to find any of my engineers, did you?
Not yet. Can you think of anything that would help me find them?
See if you can tap into our transmission tower out on the surface. Their equipment sheds will show up on your sensors.
Take care of yourself.
Be well, Shepard. We owe you.
Group! On me! Form up!
Deploying. On my way.
Thank you.
This is Dr. Himes. They found me, damn Batarians. I can hear them out there prowling around, trying to find a way in. It sounds like they're attaching something to the door. If I don't make it, tell my family I love them. This is Dr. Himes. They found me, damn Batarians. I can hear them out there prowling around. Trying to find a way in. It sounds like they're attaching something to the door. If I don't make it, tell my family I love them.
Commander, urgent message from Alliance Command coming in. I'll patch it through.
Shepard, this is Admiral Hackett from Alliance Command. We've got a situation here, and you're the only one that can handle it.
What do you need, Admiral?
There's an Alliance training ground where we test weapons and technology and live fire simulations. One of the VIs we use to simulate enemy tactics in the drills is no longer responding to our override commands. It's gone rogue.
How many casualties so far?
17 Marines were killed in the simulation exercises before we realized what had happened. That's when we contacted you. VI support is critical to our military success. They process thousands of status reports and react in nanoseconds. No human can do that. But as advanced as this thing is at military strategy, it's still just a VI. It's not self-aware, and it's completely disengaged from any networks. That's where you come in. We need you to fight your way through the training ground at the VI Corps and manually disable it.
Don't worry, Admiral. I'll take that thing out.
I know Specters answer the Council, but you're still human. You're still part of the Alliance military, and right now we need you. The VI controls all the facilities, weapons, drones, and automated defenses. You're the only one that can pull this off, Shepard. Good luck.
Message coming in. Patching it through.
The general distress call from the Sacred Angel Medical Transport. Critical system failure. Losing power. An emergency landing. Argos. Communications failing. Life support and emergency transponder. Won't last. Please hurry.